Welcome dreamers to another DIY project with me, Crash from Dream About Anything. In today's video, I'm going to make a vacuum pump from fridge compressor.
I don't know how many of you are familiar with refrigeration and how your home refrigerator works, but here's what I'm going to do.
I'll be trying to make a vacuum pump from an old fridge compressor.
The compressor is the heart of the refrigerator. It compresses the refrigerant gas, which then flows through the system and cools the air inside. I bought some things that I will need to make a vacuum pump. In this case, I won't use the compressor because it compresses the air at the outlet, but because it sucks air in at the inlet. First, I need to make a stand and a handle for it, so that it is convenient to use. As always, I'm on a tight budget. In fact, the project will be pointless if I pay too much for parts. Vacuum pumps are reasonably priced, so the low price alone makes this whole project worthwhile. This reminds me to ask you, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, to do so. This way you will help us to develop further. Perhaps some of you are wondering what a vacuum pump is for. A vacuum pump is a machine that helps to extract air from refrigeration and air conditioning installations. Why do I need it for? This summer I bought an air conditioner, but when I heard how much it would cost to install it, I decided to install it myself. But I'm going to need such a machine, so here we are. If this project works, expect a video soon of how I install my air conditioner. I've already cut everything I need for the stand. Now all I have to do is assemble it. This will be the stand. It will also have a convenient handle. Sure, I can do without it, but the compressor is quite heavy and inconvenient to carry.
But now I weld all the parts together.
After I've built everything together, I grind away any imperfections. I think it's coming out pretty well. Let me know what you think down in the comments. I've figured out a way to mount the compressor and the legs I've prepared. I'm marking the holes with spray paint. Perfect, now I know where the holes are. I'm almost done. I'm just going to add a bracket so I can wrap the cable around it. and then I will paint everything. While I wait for the paint to dry, I'm going to work on the compressor. It has three copper pipes sticking out of it. I will use a pipe cutter to cut them a little shorter. One pipe is the inlet or suction pipe, the other is the outlet or pressure pipe, and the third is the inspection pipe for charging the coolant. Here comes the hardest part of the project, which I might not be able to do. Here are these copper tips that need to be welded on the compressor tubes.
And because I don't have the tool to solder such thing, I have an idea and I'm ready to try it. Now I will try to solder the copper pipe and make some tests to see can I solder the copper pipes.
They were cleaned beforehand and one was slightly inflated so that they fit inside the other. I started with hot air and then I tried a soldering iron. In the end, only the blowtorch did the job. Usually copper pipes are soldered or weld using an oxyfuel torch, which I don't have. But maybe with the blowtorch I can finish the project.
I think the torch will do the job. I think I have managed to solder the pipes together.
Here's the result. Now I wonder if some two component adhesive would work. Wouldn't that do the job too? The stand is dry and it's time to put everything together. I've also prepared an on-off switch that I will mount in an easy and convenient place. I've hooked up the cable. All that's left is the plug. That's it, dreamers. All that left is to get it working.
And now is the time to make some tests.
I'm hooking up a hose to the outlet to see if I can pump up this tire. The compressor is pretty quiet. You can hear the air going into the tire. It did a pretty good job of inflating it. The vacuum test will be a little more difficult, but I will try to do it. I will need a vacuum gauge and a jar. important here that the gauge drop below 0, all the way to the minimum minus 1. As you can see, it's slowly but surely getting there. Well, what can I say? Expect a video of me installing an air conditioner soon. Here's how you can easily and surely make a 2-in-1 tool, a compressor and a vacuum pump. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to watch my other videos, subscribe to the channel. I was Crash from Dream About Anything. See you again in the next video.